Testing hip flexion against gravity position, patient will be seated with the knees against the table. Your patient can support themselves in this position if they need to. It won't affect the measurement. First thing you will have your patient do is perform full hip flexion to the best of their ability. So Rachel, I want you to bring your knee to your chest, as close as you can get. Okay, now come back down. I would classify that as a 3 because she was able to go into the full range of motion while in this position. Now to test for a 4 or 5, I will add resistance just proximal to the knee, but remain on the femur. And then I will stabilize the hip right back here. Okay, Rachel, I want you to bring that knee up halfway, and then I will add resistance. Resist me. 3, 2, 1. Now let it back down. Depending on that resistance given, I will classify that as a 4 or a 5. Testing hip flexion, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be in a side lying position. I will be testing the bottom leg. So in order for this leg to perform hip flexion, moving across the table, I will need to support the top leg myself. Like this. Okay, Rachel, I want you to bring this leg into hip flexion for me, and then back. Because there is movement at that joint here, I will classify that as a 2. If there is no movement, I will palpate here at the hip for this psoas major. If I feel this muscle firing, that is a 1. And if I do not feel it firing, that is a 0. Testing hip extension against gravity position. Patient will be prone. For this, we'll be testing 2 different muscles, the hamstrings and the gluteus maximus. We'll first test the hamstrings. First thing I will want my patient to do is to bring her hip all the way into extension while keeping the knee into extension as well. So go ahead and bring that hip all the way back from your ridge and then back down. I will classify that as a 3. Now to test for a 4 or a 5, what I will do is I will stabilize here up at the hip, and then I will add resistance just proximal to the knee here. So bring that up again about halfway. I'll add resistance. 3, 2, 1, bring it back down. Keep in mind these are big muscles, so I'm going to put quite a bit of resistance on them. Okay, now I will test for the gluteus maximus. So I want you to bend your knee, Rachel, okay, and then perform full hip extension again while with the knee bent. Go all the way up and back down. That is a 3 once again. To test for a 4 or 5, I will stabilize at the hip again. Come up again, Rachel. I'm gonna add resistance at the same place. Resist, 3, 2, 1, get back down. There we go. That, depending on her resistance, I will classify that as a 4 or a 5. Testing hip extension, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be side lying. We will be testing 2 different muscles in this. We will be testing the hamstrings and the gluteus maximus. Now we were going to be testing the bottom leg here. So in order for this to go into extension on the table, I will need to support the top leg myself. Support this here. Okay, Rachel, what I want you to do is I want you to bring the bottom leg into hip extension as far as you can go while keeping the knee extended. Okay, now come back. Because there's any movement whatsoever, I'm going to classify that as a 2. If there is no movement, I'm going to palpate the hamstrings here. If I feel these muscles firing, that is a 1. If I do not feel them firing, that is a 0. Now to test for the gluteus maximus, I will have her knee bent and then perform hip extension. Bring that back for me. Because there was movement, that is classified as a 2. If I do not feel any, if there is no movement, I'm going to palpate at the crease here. If I feel the gluteus maximus firing, that is a 1. And if I do not feel it firing, that is a 0. Testing hip internal rotation, also known as hip medial rotation, against gravity position. Patient will be in a seated position. We will be testing this leg. So first thing I'll have my patient do is bring their foot as far outward as possible. So go ahead and do that for me, Rachel. So you have to imagine the hip is turning inward. So bring that back. I will classify that as a 3. Now, Rachel, I want you to bring it about halfway outward. I will apply stabilize here, apply resistance on the lateral aspect, just proximal to the ankle. So resist me, 3, 2, 1, go back down. I'll classify this as a 4 or a 5 depending on her level of resistance. Testing hip internal rotation, also known as medial rotation, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be supine. We will be testing the left leg. And the first thing I'll have my patient do is point her toes inward. Because there's motion at this joint, I will classify that as a 2. If there is no movement at this joint, then I can palpate the gluteus minimus and the gluteus medius found just distal to the ASIS right here. If I feel these muscles firing, that is a 1, and if I do not feel them firing, that is a 0. Testing hip external rotation, also known as hip lateral rotation. Patient will be in a seated position. We are going to be testing this leg or this hip. So to do that, this foot needs to go inward. So to do that, we need this leg, this foot, to go outward to make sure that we have full range of motion possible for this leg. So what you will have your patient do is perform full external rotation to the best of their ability. So Rachel, I want you to bring this foot as close to that foot as you can. And now come back. Because she's able to do that, I will classify that as a 3. Now, Rachel, I want you to come at about halfway. I will stabilize here, and I will add resistance here, just proximal to the ankle. So go ahead and resist me, Rachel. 3, 2, 1, come back down. Because she's able to resist me, I will classify that as a 4 or a 5. Testing hip external rotation, also known as lateral rotation, gravity eliminated position. We will be testing the left leg. First thing I will have my patient do is point her toes away from her into hip external rotation. Okay, I'll bring them back. Because there is movement here, I will classify that as a 2. If there is no movement at the joint, then there are 6 muscles at the hip that externally rotate it, such as the obturator externus and the piriformis. Now to palpate these muscles, you're looking at the lateral side of the hip and also deep in the middle of the buttocks. And this is already a sensitive area for most patients, so you wanna be very cautious about, you know, how you palpate these muscles and if, you know, and who you're palpating on. But since these muscles are difficult to palpate, you can simply measure a 1 or a 0 depending on how much the foot moves. If you see it move at all, you know, slightly, you can classify that as 1. And if you see that there's simply no movement, you can classify that as a 0. Testing hip abduction against gravity position. Patient will be sidelined. First thing I will have my patient do is perform full hip abduction to the best of her ability. So bring your foot towards the ceiling as close as you can, Rachel, and come on back down. I will classify that as a 3. Now, to test for a 4 or 5, I will stabilize at the hip and I will apply resistance just proximal to the knee as to not cross that joint. So we'll come up halfway, Rachel, apply resistance. Now with this, these muscles are tough, so I'm gonna have to really bear down because she's young and strong. 3, 2, 1, come back down. Because she's able to do that, I will classify that as a 5, but it can also be a 4 depending on the level of resistance your patient gives you. Testing hip abduction, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be supine. First thing you'll have your patient do is perform hip abduction while in this position. So Rachel, move out your leg as far as you can go and then back again. Because she's able to do that, that would be a 2. If there is no movement, then I will palpate for the gluteus medius found here on the lateral aspect of the hip. If I feel this muscle firing, that is a 1, and if I do not feel it firing, that is a 0. Testing hip adduction against gravity position, patient will be sidelined. We will be testing the bottom leg. So what I will need to do is support the top leg to remove it out of the way. So I will support it here. Now, Rachel, what I want you to do is I want you to bring the bottom leg into adduction, the best of your ability. Bring that upward. Very good. Now bring it down. I will classify that as a 3. Now I want you to go about halfway, Rachel, and I'm going to add resistance just proximal to the knee. So resist me. 3, 2, 1. Let that back down. I will classify that as a 4 or 5, depending on the level of resistance that she gives me. Testing hip adduction, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be in a supine position. First thing I will do is I will put the hip into abduction. And then I will have my patient perform hip adduction while in this position. So go ahead and bring your foot back towards your other foot for me, Rachel. Because she's able to do that, I will classify that as a 2. I'm gonna put it into little abduction again. And if there is no movement going on, if she's not able to do any movement, then I will palpate for the hip adductors, the magnus brevis and the longus. If I feel these muscles firing, that will be a 1. And if I do not feel them firing, that will be a 0.